Hey guys, Shatter and Glass here, bringing you guys some Wanted gameplay and a 500 sub special Q&A session. Pretty excited that I'm finally putting up some Wanted because this is some really old gameplay from like December that I've been meaning to put up, but I just couldn't figure out what to pair it with. First game's from December and second game was from a few weeks ago. It seems I've found a very good place for both these in my Q&A special, and nobody asked this question, but you guys might as well learn that Wanted is my favorite free-for-all mode. So, point is, I've never put up free-for-all gameplay, so I really hope you guys enjoy this. I have about 150-ish sessions of Wanted play to date, and I've been trying to get that 10k for ages, but it's just not happening. So I kind of give up. I keep getting 9.6s. 9.6 exactly. That seems to just be my cutoff number. It's happened like 3 times now, and in the second game you're about to watch in here, you're gonna see that I had a 9.6 with 2 minutes left. And can you believe in those 2 minutes, I did not score a single point. Not a single freaking point. I swear it's double, you know? 9, 96, 69, flip the 9 upside down, and it's a 6 and vice versa. Anyway, I thought I might as well just put it up already, so. They're not 10Ks, but they're decent, so yeah, on to the questions now. I have a bad habit of just rambling. The first question's from Emvidasch. What was your first tattoo and did it have a special meaning? My first tat was actually like on my hip down here, and it was really small. It was about 1 inch or 3 centimeters, whatever that is for you guys in the metric system. And it said strength in Chinese. But later on, I went to the doctor and he saw my tat and he went, you know, that means like physical strength. Is that what you wanted it to mean? And I'm like, I wanted it to mean like emotional or mental whatever strength. And he was like, nope, that means physical strength. And I was like, oh shit. So I went and got a huge cover up for that. I put like a rose on it to cover it up. And then I ended up getting this huge rib piece that extends all the way till here. So yeah, it's all the way down in my hip, all the way up. So once you get tats, it seems that you can't just stick to getting one. Would you do a duet with Havok singing Friday together? No. Are you a student or are you working already, and what do you do for a living? I actually am a student. I'm a full-time student. I've been a full-time student for 4 years. I go to a California State University, and I'm still going, and I'm a little bit behind, and I hope to graduate next year, but I have no clue what's gonna happen. So am I working already? I had a job, and because of reasons I don't want to state, I had to quit that job. But I was a teacher at an elementary school, and I taught little children. My first year there, I taught 3rd and 4th graders. My second year there, I taught 1st and 2nd graders. I always had the special combo classes because I was pretty good with them. And the last year that I taught, which was just last year, I taught 5th and 6th graders. It was a private Christian school. But I don't do that anymore. Currently, I tutor children for a living. So that pays pretty well. I get like $25 to $30 an hour. Next question, also from Emvidasch. Does Havok wrestle kangaroos? No, he does not wrestle kangaroos, but interestingly enough, he eats kangaroo meat. I know some Aussies are very against it, but some Aussies are not, unfortunately, even though it's their national icon, which I just can't fathom, because like, that's like, I don't know. That's kind of like Americans eating the bald eagle, you know? It's just uncool, but he eats kangaroo meat, what can I say? And every time he buys kangaroo meat, he'll like put it on the webcam for me to see, hey, I got kangaroo meat, and I'm just like, no, no. Next, from Emvidasch. Is there any game that was capable of making you cry during the story? No. I don't really play single player, so. Favorite dish?
Revenge.
That's really hard. I like Vietnamese food because I am Vietnamese. And I love pasta. I really like steak. I love steak. I'm a meat girl. How did you and Havok meet? We met on ACB. I think the whole world knows that now. From Emvidasch, the last question. My favorite vegetable. My favorite vegetable has to be... That's a hard one. I love veggies. I was always a veggie kid. I always preferred veggies over the meat when I was young. I'm a little bit of an oddball. I love broccoli. And finally, we are done with Emvidasch's questions. Free Quarrel 13 asked, will you do an open lobby? I can do an open lobby, but I've never really thought about it. So maybe in the future. Nax Prime asked, will you play Over the Rainbow on your ukulele? I love it when you do that. I am a sub for life. The lyrics, dreams really do come true. Crispy, what's your gamer tag? Crispy. Okay, the point is, crispy something with 13 at the end. Asked, would you mind saying pepperoni, mushrooms, sausage, olives, cheese, and pizza in a somewhat Italian accent in order?
Pepperoni, mushrooms, sausage, olives, cheese, pizza.
Next question from Mr. HisokasenHisokasen. What do you like tattoos? I think there's a typo there, dude. I think you meant to ask why do you like tattoos? Are they a way to express yourself? If it wasn't for them, in what way would you express yourself except for music? Are they a way to express myself? Yes, I would say yes. I feel as though I could lose everything, and if I had myself, my brain, my thoughts, my psyche, my whatever philosophical crap, I will be okay. I think, therefore I am, is kind of my motto. I love to write. I keep a journal, and I write a lot, and I'm generally pretty open about my feelings and how I feel. That's certainly a way of expressing myself, my voice, and my writing. Mr. AssassinMan91 asked, my question is, what kind of music do you like? I like all kinds of music, actually. I love some classical music. I like heavy metal sometimes. I love soundtracks. I especially love soundtracks. I love the Memoirs of a Geisha soundtrack by John Williams, if you guys know him. He's written like music for that, music for Star Wars, music for some really popular films. John Williams is awesome. I like pop. I like Christina Aguilera is my favorite pop singer. I like everything. I really do. I've been around and studied music since I was 8 or 9 years old, so I really have an appreciation for all types of music. The most popular question that I got asked about three times. Havok, Not Yet Pro, The Propaganda, The Mighty Sin, and somebody else who I cannot remember, who I'm pretty sure asked me this question too, asked, when are you coming back to visit Havok? Unfortunately, I don't know. I really wish I knew when I could come back to Australia, but I don't know. But he's coming in August, so that's about 30-something days, so I'll get to see him again, and we'll probably do a vlog together or something like that. Dear Shattering Glass, why did you get Milhouse started on that fucking creeper mask? Mollycat asks, how did it become official between you and your Aussie love? Meaning, like, did any of you do any romantic gesture to let the other person know you were interested, or did you just both know? I hope this is not too personal. No, it's not too personal. I'm pretty open about my relationship, and to answer your question, how did it become official? Well, after we met on ACB, we started talking. He started inviting me to games periodically, and we got to know each other like normal friends did, or would. I started flirting with him. I started flirting with him, and I flirted with him quite a bit, excessively, actually. And he never showed any real interest, and he was kind of just, like, he just didn't respond, and I just kept going, and I kept flirting with him. After a while, he started expressing, like, he started flirting back too, and it took a really long time. Basically, I took an Xbox hiatus for about 5 months. I didn't play my Xbox. I actually let a friend borrow it, and then I bought a PS3. I played on that for a while, and he would Facebook me and be like, "You suck for having PS3. Come back to Xbox. Hurry up and get your Xbox back." And I finally did. It kind of just happened that way. And on Valentine's Day of 2012, he wrote me a really, really, really sweet Valentine's Day poem, and we kind of just hit it off from there. But we didn't do anything, we didn't date officially until we met in Australia, because we just weren't sure how it was going to end up, and we wanted to make sure we really liked each other in real life as well as online. So yeah. What is your favorite place in the world and why? Well, I don't mean to be really cheesy, but my favorite place in the world would have to be beside my Aussie love, because it doesn't really matter where in the world I am. As long as I'm with him, I think I'll be pretty happy. And yeah, I don't know. It could be anywhere. Arcane Tempest asked, who did you first... He asked a few, so bear with me. Who did you first meet on AC that you remember and maybe are still friends with now? The very first person I met on AC on a personal level, like I actually started talking to them, was Havok. Before that, I didn't talk to anybody who played the game. I generally just played on my own, and I had a couple of friends, but they definitely weren't from the AC community, so it was Havok that brought me into this community. What other types of games do you play or like? I like fighting games. Marvel vs. Capcom, Mortal Kombat, Street Fighter, I love those games. I think one of my favorite games of all time, aside from AC, is actually Resident Evil 5. What is your favorite color? I'm a really girly girl. My favorite color is pink. When you were a kid, what did you want to be when you grew up? When I was a kid, I wanted to be a veterinarian because I loved animals, and I still love animals. But since I was 11, I've wanted to be a lawyer, and I've kind of stuck to that dream since, and it's been 11 years now that I've aspired to be a lawyer one day, so yeah, I think that's where I'm headed. Sebia Rain asks, what do you do for a living, and do you like what you do? I swear somebody previously already asked that, and I said I was a school teacher and that I was tutoring. Or that I am tutoring currently. Yes, I very much enjoy what I do. I enjoy working with children, and it's very, very rewarding for me to see them grow and develop through learning, and it amazes me how much a child can really take in and how children learn, and I definitely do have a passion for teaching. Senile Old Coot asked, first game you ever played? First game I ever played on my Xbox, well, you know what? First game in general, actually. Let's go there. First game that I ever played was Yoshi's Island on the Super Nintendo. Inspiration behind your gamer tag. And this wasn't just asked by Senile Old Coot, this was also asked by Hellbilly. The inspiration behind my gamer tag. Goes back very far, and it's actually a very personal story, but I guess I could talk about it a little bit. There was a period of time in my life where I was a very, very angry child, and every time I looked into the mirror, I just wanted to smash it. I wanted to destroy the mirror because I had a lot of self-esteem issues growing up, and I was bullied, and I was beat up in school a lot by some of the children, other children. And, you know, growing up, things were hard, and, you know, when I got older, I was still bullied, and I was still picked on, and I really had some self-esteem issues and some, you know, anger issues with myself and with the world that I had to struggle and get over. I've had my gamer tag on my emails and other usernames since I was like 13. So the name Shattering Glass has stuck to me all these years, even though I'm a lot more positive now and I've grown and I've changed as a person, but the Shattering Glass thing still kind of sticks. The most ridiculous or funny thing that you've ever seen on AC. The most ridiculous thing I've ever seen on AC is when I got stuck to the ground for like 2 minutes. No, more than 2 minutes. It was like, I was unwanted on Fort Walcott, and after I ground finished, a guy on the ground, obviously he's on the ground, it's ground finished, I got stuck to the ground. And you can see that video in the link provided. Man, it was hilarious, but it was frustrating at the same time. So definitely check that little video out. It's like 3 minutes long and it shows you what happened. Well, either yourself or Havok make that 8,000 mile journey for good. We've talked about it, and that's a really tough issue for us. We don't know what's gonna happen, and we're just trying to take it day by day. And as of now, he has a really good job, and I'm doing pretty well here myself in America. And you know, if he were to move here, he wouldn't have the same job, and you know, his opportunities wouldn't be as great. If I moved over there, it would be awesome, but my family is very traditional, and they probably disown me if I did. So it's you know, it's a battle right now for us between, you know, taking it slow and really figuring out what's good for us and what's best for us. And you know, we don't really mind taking it slow because through the distance, we've stayed true to each other, and we'll get there. Last question from Senile Old Coot. Why are you so awesome? I'm really nice until you cross me. And Senile, you probably just think I'm really awesome because you're really awesome yourself, and like, I'm awesome to people who are awesome to me. So, I hope that answers it. Joe Blackler asked, how do you feel about the way Assassin's Creed as a game is changing? When I went to the Uplay Lounge, I got to test out AC4, and it's definitely, in my opinion, going to be amazing. And I really regret not asking the question of how matchmaking's gonna be, because that's the one thing that concerns me. We're gonna have the options in AC4 multiplayer to customize all of these things and, you know, make it our own, and I feel like we're all gonna have fun with that, but the matchmaking still worries me. I'm wondering how they're going to do private matchmaking and just how the servers are gonna be in general, and I really feel like that'll be a huge factor in the success of the game, the multiplayer at least, and how it's going to be perceived. iRossa asks, how do you think the AC Manhunt season is going so far? I gotta say, I've seen a lot of bad things, and I myself have experienced my fair share of drama in the seasonal. And I mean, the idea for the seasonal was fantastic and it was great, and I was so glad that iRossa and some of the other officials were making it happen. But the Manhunt seasonal to me is, man, it's like half fun, half drama. You just never know what you're gonna get. And some people are gonna get really mad over really dumb things, and you know, I don't know, like half the teams have dropped out, even though, I mean, it sucks so bad for some of those teams who really wanted to participate and couldn't, and you're gonna take their spot and then you're just gonna drop out. Aerides 67 asks, what is your favorite place you'd like to live? I would love to move to Australia and be with Havok. But I love America too. I love my home country, and I love Southern California. You know, this is my home, this is where I was raised. What is your favorite pet or animal? I love, love. This goes out to you, Ninkin. I love cats. I love kittens. I'm allergic to them though, unfortunately. What are the favorite types of drawings you like to draw? I love drawing portraits. Otherwise, my interest in drawing other things is not really there. I love drawing people, I've only started drawing portraits really recently, and I don't have much experience, and I've actually only successfully drawn like 3 portraits. But I hope to draw more in the future. But usually when I draw portraits, it's off like impulse, and it's not really something that I do regularly. So yeah, but yeah, I like to draw people. Nova Mage, or Nova Star Dragon as I know him on Xbox Live, asked, why did I start making YouTube videos? And you guys wouldn't believe it, but I started making YouTube videos because of the Valentine special. I know that I had videos up way before the Valentine special, but my sole purpose of why I started recording in the first place was just to make that video for Havok for Valentine's Day. It was actually supposed to be for Christmas, but it just took me forever to figure things out and to get some good clips and stuff, so I ended up releasing it as a Valentine's Day special, and it was appropriate anyway, turned out great anyway, so, you know, better late than never, right? Mama 5 asked, boxers or briefs? Well, I would have to say briefs, only because Havok has a really nice butt. I mean, it's pretty embarrassing when, like, your boyfriend has a nicer butt than you do. Ninkin asked me, what is your favorite or most memorable thing you've ever pulled off in AC multiplayer? You know, that's a really hard one because I'm pretty much just a Manhunt player, and a lot of things you do in Manhunt definitely aren't as cool as the things you do in, like, Assassinate or Artifact Assault. Because, you know, in Manhunt you wall a lot, so... Yeah, I'm not one to do crazy tricks and do some crazy free running and stuff. So I would just have to say my most memorable moment in AC3 was the first time I pulled off a really high score of like 14.6, and it just felt really good, I guess. Zorboid Orb asked, number one, me or Millie, choose now. Okay, how about neither? I love you both, and you both have your positives, and you both do things that make me really happy, and you both are funny, and you both are... Number two, where do you see yourself 3 years from now? Well, I am currently 22 years of age, and in 3 years I will be 25. At 25 years old, I see myself possibly almost finishing law school, or at least like trying to get into law school. Definitely engaged to Havok already, so that's where I see myself 3 years from now. I don't want to have kids, at least not until I'm 28 or so. I want to enjoy myself, I want to travel the world, and there's a lot of things that I want to enjoy in life without being held down by children. Number three, from Zorb, if not AC, which other game? Resident Evil 5. Or I would love to play a first-person shooter game, but I have simulator sickness, and I get really, really sick when I play games. It's like motion sickness. Not games, sorry. First-person shooter games. IntoDeep202 asked me, what is your least favorite thing about AC in general? My most favorite thing about AC is the community itself. My least favorite thing about AC is also the community itself. You know, there are some wonderful, great, fun-loving people in this community, and there are people in this community who seem to be just out there to ruin it for everybody. So that's gotta be my least favorite thing about AC in general. Roscoe, I think he's Scottish. Sorry, random fact. Asked me, giant pandas or red pandas? Both, but red pandas definitely have an edge over giant pandas, at least for me. Dutch Crusade asked, Shattering Glass, when did you start gaming and why? Well, I started gaming actually when I was very young, about 5 or 6 years old, on a Super Nintendo. And then I had a PS, the very first PlayStation, and I didn't play games for a long time until I got my Xbox 360, which I've had for about 2 years now. 3 years now, 2 years now, 2 years, 2 years and a half. I started gaming because I started getting really close to a childhood friend when we got older. I would come over to this person's house a lot, and they had an Xbox 360, and I decided to get an Xbox 360 after that, because I was like, I need to play my own games, and I want to do my own stuff. I don't want to just keep coming over to their house and playing on their Xbox. So what is your favorite and least favorite AC single player? My most favorite AC single player has to be Assassin's Creed 2. That game, I don't think I even finished, and it was still amazing from beginning to end, at least from what I covered. My least favorite AC single player, well, I haven't played the rest, so I can't tell you. I'm not much of a single player person. It takes too much patience, and I'm not very patient. And I don't know. It's really hard for me to go through single player games. My favorite multiplayer, that's a really, really hard one, because each multiplayer has had its pros and cons, in my opinion. And if I really had to choose, I don't know. I really love the versatility of AC3 multiplayer, but I also loved Brotherhood, so it's really hard to say. Leafy asked, what was my funniest moment from high school? That's a really hard one. My funniest moment from high school, I have a really bad, like, I have a good memory, but I kind of have a really bad memory of high school because I didn't really have the greatest high school experience ever. I mean, I did a lot of extracurricular activities and all this cool stuff, but I miss those extracurricular activities, and I miss, you know, the sports and stuff like that, but I can't answer that one because I really can't think of anything. One of the questions that somebody asked me has gotten lost somewhere, and I really can't find it, but I know I was asked this, what sports I played in high school or something like that. I played tennis, I did color guard, marching band, I did water polo, and I was on the swim team, and aside from music in high school, water polo and swimming were definitely my passions. I was very fit at the time, I was like buff. Kind of like muscular, not buff per se, but water polo and swimming were definitely my loves in high school. I asked for a last call on Q&A questions on Twitter, so I'm gonna quickly check to see if anybody asked me anything else before I end this. Oh, I got a question from J-Dog, my UK man. He asked, what will your next tattoo be? I really want to get something symbolic for Havok being in my life, but he has rejected the idea because he doesn't like tats on me. So I probably won't be getting any tats for a while, but if I could, it'd probably be like a quote, like love conquers all or something. I'm sure many of you know already, but if you don't know, I guess I should share something with you guys before ending this vlog. Nothing is true. Everything is permitted. You guys are very familiar with that and where it comes from, so I'm gonna end that vlog here. Thank you so much for 500 subscribers, guys, and thank you so much for 600 something that I have right now. I think 632. I will be doing a 666 subscriber special because my birthday is on June 6th, which is 6-6. My favorite number is 6. Oh, I think the propaganda. Actually, I missed a question. Last question is, yes, the propaganda asked me, what is your social security number? I can't tell you that, but my social security number starts with the 6 and ends with the 6. Until next time, bye!